guys.
Welcome to my channel, where we'll be discussing family, faith, hope, and love. I'm so glad that you joined me. Let's be fed daily bread. Are you hungry? Welcome to my channel. I hope that this message finds you doing well. If this is your very first time tuning in, this is my digital journey. I have been led by the Holy Spirit to drop you golden nuggets each and every day. So go ahead and subscribe to my channel and please share it with your family and friends. Let them know that you found someone who is dropping golden nuggets and it will help you in your day-to-day living. So, I am so happy that you're with me today. Welcome, family and friends. Love you guys. Thank you for your love, your support, your encouragement. And I am glad that you have joined me on this digital journey. I hope you're keeping up. Today is actually day 101, episode 101. And if you had an opportunity to look at my 100th episode yesterday, you would see the direction that the Holy Spirit is leading me, okay? So go ahead, look at it. And now today, we're moving forward. I read Luke chapter 2, and the word that the Holy Spirit gave me to talk to you today about is treasure. Yes, treasure. So with that being said, let's dive right in. I went ahead and completed reading the chapter. And before I even completed reading it, as soon as I got to Luke chapter 2, verse 19, the Holy Spirit said, treasure is the word. And I was like, okay. So if you read, or if you remember anything about the book of Luke, it's basically giving you the story of Jesus and everything that transpired. So yesterday I discussed Luke chapter 1 and the word was receive. Today with treasure, Luke chapter 19, it says, Mary quietly treasured these things in her heart and often thought about them. And I think what the Holy Spirit wants me to let you know today is that what it is that you have in your heart, whatever you treasure, that is where your heart is going to be leading you to on a regular basis. I know there's scripture out there about what your heart treasures. I think it's in Matthew. I don't have that specific chapter right in front of me because I wasn't led to give it to you. I'm only going by based on me studying the Bible that I can recall. But it was specifically Luke 2, 19, is what we're talking about with Mary, because we're going over the book of Luke, okay? So let me get you this scenario. We know about Mary and Joseph. Yesterday we discussed about Mary getting the word that she will have a son. Now the baby is already born in Luke chapter 2, okay? We've got Joseph and Mary doing what the things that they're required to do with the law, getting the census, going back, you know, to make sure that they're in compliance. But with all that being said, it's in reference to the scene where there is this prophet by the name of Simeon. And there's a prophetess by the name of Anna that was at the temple as well. What the Holy Spirit wanted me to bring to your attention, because there's a lot of things sometimes you read And it all depends on your faith level. It goes over your head. And what it is that he wanted me to let you know about Simeon is that Simeon had already gotten a word from the Holy Spirit. And what you need to know as well, that Simeon was filled with the Holy Spirit. And he was having an expectation of the Messiah. Simeon was expecting to see the Messiah because the Holy Spirit tell him that he will not die until he see the Messiah. Okay? So with that being said, he had an expectation. No matter how long it took, Simeon was expecting to see what it is that the Holy Spirit told him that he was going to see. How many times that you have been led, have a vision, or you know full well that this is something that God is leading you to, but you just don't, you take it for granted and you have no expectations at all? So this is to show you that whatever it is that God tells you, you have to be a willing participant to say, okay, I'm going to believe this. I'm going to keep this with me. I'm going to be like Mary. I'm going to treasure it, okay, into my heart. Because with that being said, Simeon was able, he was led by the Holy Spirit to go to the temple at the same time while Mary and Joseph was there. So he got to meet the Messiah. He got to meet baby Jesus. And he was going on and on and on and on about praising the baby and thanking God that he had this opportunity to meet the Messiah and letting the other people know that who are waiting to see the Messiah, that the Messiah is here. And then Anna was in the same temple and she heard what Simeon was talking about and she came to confirm that as well. So think about it. You've got some people who have been filled with the Holy Spirit while Jesus was a baby. Interesting, isn't that? Okay? And letting now people know that, hey, prophecy has been fulfilled. So you've got to be able to, when you're reading these stories, you need to break it down and see exactly what was transpiring and look at it at a different lens, okay? So the message for today, not alone that now Mary is treasuring, she's seeing all this, because you got to think about it. The angels came, right? And the angels told her about how they were visited by the angels, and she was like, okay, wow, let me treasure this, and she kept that in her heart. And then there's a second part of it as well in Luke, chapter 2, when they're talking about Jesus now, he is 12 years old. And he went to the temple and he was there teaching the, you know, the teachers and the scholars. He was having deep conversation with them, and Mary and Joseph were frantic because it was like, where is Jesus? Where is Jesus? And then when they found him in the temple, just there having discussion, they was like, you have me and Joseph frantic, son. What it is that you're doing? And he was like, I don't know why you're frantic. I'm in my father's house. You know, this is where I would be, in my father's house. At that time, they didn't quite understand what he was talking about. But I will let you know that they definitely now know that the things that Jesus, that God had told them, was now being resonated, and they can basically see where this whole thing was going. So that's the second thing that Mary treasured. She was paying close attention and she was treasuring all that and keeping it into her heart and figuring out exactly what it is now that she needs to do. And the scripture tells you basically then that from that instant at 12 years old, he was obedient to his earthly parents, Mary and Joseph, so that they can be able to cover him while he was there on earth so he could grow up to do his father's business. Okay? So what you need to know and what the golden nugget is for today is about treasure, is that when we treasure the things of this world, our heart is far from the Lord. But as you can see in the scripture, that Mary treasured the things of God and she was able to do the assignment that she was called to do. So the nugget for today is that let us treasure the things of the Lord and unrelentingly pursue after righteousness. and godliness and faith and love and perseverance and gentleness and humility of heart and joy in the Lord. And for when we treasure the Lord, we will be rooted and grounded in Jesus, and our heart will be anchored on the rock of eternal salvation. So, are you hungry? I know that I am. Let's be fed daily bread.